Before we get to San Francisco, our last stop on the RV trip is Santa Cruz. And we have set up for the seven of us to take a surf lesson. We have never surfed before, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
Why do you keep looking at me?
Because I know it's probably not, you know, on his bucket list, but...
It's not. I usually do not like getting my face wet.
Not usually. You don't like getting your face wet.
I do not like getting my face wet. Why do you want to get all this wet? I mean...
But why does it bother? Like... Oh, 25 years and I still don't have an answer to that.
So we're gonna paddle.
Oh, not really. Mine's too short.
Ty, we'll take care of you. Okay, and then what we're gonna do from there, we're gonna get ourselves to a standing position. So if you want, let's see how you guys would stand up on a surfboard. Why don't you show me? Oh, this is gonna be epic. You guys are gonna do killer.
You have to come to your feet real quick. Well, that's easy for all of us because we have short arms and short legs and we can tuck up and stand up quick. I mean,
it's super easy to go from laying flat to up on your feet when you're on the beach. But I'm sure once we're in the water, it's gonna be a little more challenging.
So, like that. So I want you to put it on one leg at a time. Get it up to your hip.
Through this?
Yep, through that.
Little people in wetsuits are pretty attractive.
Cute.
We're like little walruses or little seals or something. Like little flapper. Or.
Yeah, let up, yeah.
Alex, you need help?
My wetsuit was really a challenge trying to put it on. Like I couldn't put it on, and the instructor tried to help me, but like I was practically bungee jumping, so trying to pull it up, and I was going up with the wetsuit, so it was like impossible to take it, put it on. It did work out in the end. After a few shakes, it did work out in the end.
I found that. Good job.
One of the key things that the instructor told us about surfing was keep your feet on the board but paddle out with your arms. That was a bit of a challenge for us because the surfboards were so wide and our arms so short. We were like flippers. Just our hands could only, on a lot of us, just so we couldn't paddle out very fast. We could get out there, but not very fast.
You're like up on the board, standing upright, but and then the next thing you know, you're like flipped off and your hair's every which way and salt water's going up your nose and surfboard's flipped over.
All the more reason to stay on your surfboard.
On the first try, I got to get up on the board and I guess it didn't like angle myself right or my balance wasn't good or both and I fell. But it hurts pretty bad.
I mean, I could just tell in his face, because, I mean, he was, like, you know...
Upset.
Crying, pain, upset. Alex has tubes in his ears due to the fact that he has achondroplasia dwarfism. Our Eustachian tube sits very flat. The ear will build up with fluid. It cannot drain the fluid, so then it causes ear infections, and it also causes hearing loss. And so salt water going into the ear, it is. It's extremely,
painful.
Extremely painful.
Here, lay down on this, put your that head down.
You just have to lay and let the water and hope that the water drains out on its own. And fortunately, everything ended up about 30 minutes of laying on that ear.
Drained out.
It drained out. The pain, you know, subsided to a point, you know, that he was able to go on with the rest of the day. So we were okay.
Felt
felt great. Riding your first wave was awesome. And you just want to keep doing it over and over again because it just gets addicting.
I thought surfing was a total success. I learned a lot in such a short period of time. It seemed easy, you know, to pick up on. And yeah, I'm already ready to go back out.
I loved surfing. I would definitely do it all the time. It was very successful.
You know, we feel like surfing is definitely a, I don't want to say a little people friendly sport, but definitely a achondroplasia friendly sport. And the reason being is, you know, low center of gravity. It's pretty easy for us to pop up on the surfboard.
I never taught little people, and you know what? I'm really stoked we did because it was rad to watch them surf. They did great. Every single one of them rode a wave and rode it to the beach, which was awesome.
Oh, that's thrashing, dude. Radical. Yeah, gnarly.
The surfing lingo. That was transferred.
Shred it. He's like, dude, you shredded that. And I'm like, I didn't even fall. What are you talking about? I surfed all the way in. Yeah, I know, man. You shredded it. I'm like, no, I rode the wave. But apparently, shredding it is like, badass. You did a good job.
The big kahuna shredded it.
No more big daddy. It was big kahuna. Big kahuna with dry hair.
I'm not going to start calling Trent Big Kahuna.
I think the trip was really made for us when we got to surf. That was like everybody's favorite part about this whole trip.
Not for me. I had the risk of an ear infection. I got water in my ear. I wiped out on the first try. I'm not really sure if surfing was really my best day of the entire week.